Hi friends, Angular 19 has been released. In this video, I'm going to talk about the new features those got introduced in Angular 19. Let's start with a big one, standalone components. Traditionally, Angular components have been tightly coupled to ng modules. But with standalone components, we can create components that are independent of ng modules. Standalone components were first introduced in Angular 14 and got stabilized in Angular 15. Till Angular 16, while creating a component using the ng-generate-component command, we can use the flag --standalone to create a standalone component. But starting from Angular 17, if you are going to create a component using the ng-generate-component command, it will create the standalone component by default. If you want to create a non-standalone component, you need to give this command with the flag --no-standalone. And for standalone components, we can see this flag in the @component decorator till Angular 18. But starting from Angular 19, standalone components will not have this flag, but the components are standalone by default. If you need to make the component non-standalone, then we need to specify the flag standalone false. So, like I said before in one of my previous videos on standalone components, Angular is slowly moving towards standalone. So, get familiar with standalone components. Okay, the next big thing is signals. Signals offer a fresh approach to manage state and reactivity within Angular application. Signals were first introduced in Angular 16 and got stabilized in Angular 17. In Angular 18, some new APIs like input, model, and queries APIs like view child, view children, content child, content children got introduced and they were in developer preview. In Angular 19, these APIs got stabilized. In addition to that, in Angular 19, Angular team has introduced two new APIs, link signal and resource API. I will create a more detailed video on these APIs soon. Okay, the next one is refactoring tools. Migrating to a new version can sometimes be a difficult task. But whenever a new feature is introduced, Angular team is creating some refactoring tools to automate the migration. For example, we have refactoring tools for migrating to standalone approach, migrating to new control flow syntaxes, and so on. In Angular 19, three new refactoring tools have been introduced: signal input migration, signal queries migration, and output migration. We can use these tools to migrate our existing component inputs, outputs, and queries to use the new signals API. It automates the process, making the transition smoother and less error prone. Okay, apart from the above mentioned features, Angular team has also brought some other exciting improvements. Matte.theme. This feature makes it easier to customize Angular material themes, giving us more control over the look and feel of our applications. Incremental hydration. This performance optimization technique can significantly improve the initial load time of our Angular applications. In upcoming videos, we will explore more on these topics. I encourage you to explore these features and start using them in your next project. As always, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video. Thank you. Bye.